We all love the sound of money, and a $1,500 sign-on bonus sounds even better. That's right, Belicio Foods of Jackson is offering a $1,500 sign-on bonus to new employees. Receive an extra $100 your first 6 weeks, then $400 after day 90, and $500 after day 180. Don't wait. Apply online at BeliciOFoods.com/careers today. That's BeliciOFoods.com/careers. Come work for a company who truly values their employees. Come work for Belicio Foods. It's time to reveal the prize and clue start dates for Cycle Search 2022, presented by Total Media, along with the Tri-State Power Sports Superstore, Honda Suzuki Polaris Can-Am of Jackson. This year's prize is a KO250 dirt bike, along with an accessory package valued at over $4,500. That's right, a KO250 dirt bike. Clues begin on Monday, February 14th, Valentine's Day. There'll be one clue each day, Monday through Friday, till the prize pack is found. Pack is hidden somewhere in the listening area. Be safe when searching, and good luck. It's Cycle Search 2022, sponsored by Total Media and Honda Suzuki Polaris Can-Am of Jackson.
I've had it in the morning, the afternoon.
Well, good morning, everyone. We were talking. Yeah. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to The Morning Show right here on Main Street TV. Of course, Jennifer here to start off her morning with our good friend, Butch Aldrich. And, you know, Butch has had many, many, many hats here in town. Welcome to the program. But you have on your Trout Festival hat today.
That's right. Today, we're making our plans and getting ready for the Jackson County Trout Festival.
So it is on this year. So we're so excited and glad to have it back. Now, I think you guys had it last year, didn't you?
We did have it last year, yes.
Yep.
And and it actually was pretty much a success last year compared with, you know, with the way everything was going.
Yes.
But people were really looking for a reason to get outside.
You know, you're exactly right. And the Trout Festival is one of those things that just kind of kicks off the spring. And I feel like it just, it's such a good, like, family event. And it gets the entire family out. They can spend the whole day out at our absolutely phenomenal and gorgeous Lake Hammertown. And what a better way to spend a Saturday.
Oh, yeah. It's nice. There's a lot of, if the weather's good, then it's going to be really good. I've been out there when it snowed, and very few people showed up, but yeah, it's a lot of fun for families. It is family geared.
It is definitely family oriented.
Yes.
Yes, absolutely. All right. So let's get down to, first off, how did the Trout Festival get started? Do you remember?
Well, what I know, and I was thinking about that this morning, the Trout Festival is about 45 years old.
No way.
Yeah. And I've been part of it for 41 of those. But they started before I ever went to work for the police department, and about 4 years before that.
Wow.
And it started out where they used to just cord off a little area at one of the boat drops, and they had a place for kids to fish. That's
okay.
Kind of the way it started. Because what they did is they netted it around, they released some fish, and then small kids could actually just fish along that area there. And of course,
so it was literally fish in a barrel.
Right, basically that, yeah. And it was all, at that time, it was just for the kids.
Aww.
And then it progressed to we wanted it to be a family operation.
Yeah.
And we wanted to include, you know, to get the parents and everything else. So what we did is now they do the trout drop, which is the day before on the 15th. And we lock the gate. You're not allowed to fish at the time that they put the trout in. You have to wait till the following morning. The gate opens up at 6 a.m. And from that point, you can go and get your rush to your favorite fishing spot. And start fishing.
There you go. And there are rewards for finding those great fish, because there's prizes and all kind of things. So you have all day to come up with the heaviest fish and you know, win some fun stuff.
Yeah, it's done by weight, and we actually have two categories. There's four large trophies. We also have felt that an 8-year-old shouldn't be competing against a 30-year-old with a bass boat.
Yeah, it makes sense.
So what happens is we have the largest trout, and it's 16 and under is one trophy, and from that on up to 100 is the other trophy. And it's the same way with a game fish. The game fish, and these are all done by weight.
Okay.
And it's and all there's no cost to this to anybody.
No, it's just
you
fun.
Come in and you fish, and you know I've had several calls this week. People wanting me to tell them all the rules. Well, the first main important is you have to abide by all the rules in the state of Ohio when it comes to fishing. Licenses, boats have to have their tags on
yes.
them. You have to have your vests in the boat. You have to do all that same thing. And the yep. only other rules, and I think you have a limit of catching five, and there's also length that has to do with the length of a fish to be able to keep it, and I'm not exactly sure what that is. I don't remember that.
Okay.
But other than that, it's just come and catch your fish. If you want it weighed, you bring it to the shelter house on the park side.
Okay.
Okay, the big shelter house.
Yes.
And then you bring it in. We weigh the fish. If you bring in the heaviest fish at that moment, we put you on a form and you're there, and it has, you know, your name, your address, and what the weight of the fish and what the fish was.
Okay.
And then at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, whoever has the largest trout or the largest game fish in either one of the upper or lower categories wins a nice trophy.
There you go. And it's fun.
And speaking of trophies, too, we actually also, we have in the afternoon, generally starting about 1 o'clock, we have a casting contest.
Yes.
And it's based on three age brackets. There's a 6 and under. There is a 11 to 7, and then above that to age 17. And then we have girls and boys brackets.
Okay.
And it's the casting contest consists of casting into a ring, or better known as a hula hoop. And
we're high tech.
We're high tech. That's right. And whoever can get it into the ring wins the trophy.
There you go. And then afterwards, you have to show off your hula hoop skills.
Yeah.
No, not really.
We're going to save that for you.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah. Hey, I can hula hoop. That's okay. One of the few things I can do in this world.
You're going to come out about 1 o'clock and
hula hoop away. Yes. So, okay. So the Jackson County Trout Festival is not this coming weekend. It's next Saturday.
That's right. That's correct. A week from this coming Saturday.
Okay. And it will be at Hammertown Lake. Now, you said on the park side. Now, is the park side off of the Jisco West Road, or is the park side off of, you just go straight up South Street?
No, it's not straight up. You go to the left and you go around Jisco, and then you go in that direction.
Yes. Just follow the signs.
Yeah. It's where, you know, they have the shelter house built. They used to have some playground equipment there that they've had to end up taking out, but they haven't replaced them yet.
Mm-hmm.
There's a the largest boat dock is on that side.
Okay.
And you can see it. I mean, for people who have not been there, it's a beautiful view of the lake.
It is absolutely gorgeous. And I know I just love to go out there and sit and think, no thoughts.
Right.
But no, it's a really nice place to just go, and it's just beautiful. And as I've told you, I think numerous times, both on and off the air, I have some friends that do competitive fishing with sponsors and the whole nine yards. And one of them stopped by the brewery not too long ago, and he was just floored because he went out and fished Hammertown, and he just said, "That is the prettiest lake." It's so clear. It is just gorgeous out there.
Yeah.
And he was so surprised. He lives up in the Athens County area, and he was just like, wow.
Well, it's very well kept, and that's due to the city of Jackson. Their people work very hard to make it look and keep it in that, you know, like keep it where it's beautiful. It is a nice place to go. And people, you know, will go there and picnic with the picnic tables and that type of thing. So there's a lot of use to that. I mean, it's a nice place.
It is absolutely gorgeous. Not to mention, we need to keep it clean and safe because it's our water supply, right?
Exactly.
So, you know, we need to treat her very well. So, all right, what kind of, Butch, what kind of boats and things are allowed restriction-wise? I know you can't have like a big motor or anything like that.
Well, that's basically it. There's, other than the size of the motor, there's not, I mean, I've seen little small pontoons and that type of thing on there. You're supposed to use some sort of a trolley motor. You're not supposed to use any other kind of a motor except what they call a trolley motor.
Okay.
Because the speed is kept down because it only has so much power.
Gotcha.
As far as the boat's concerned, you can use about anything. People use canoes and they use other
kayaks.
And you know, it's like the kayak that we're giving away is actually considered to be a fishing kayak.
Yeah, absolutely. And we have a picture of that. There it is. Thank you, James, for putting that up there. And so what makes a kayak a fishing kayak? I assume that it has certain attachments and things.
Well, this one right here, what it does is, one, it has a wet well. In other words, something that you can put some of the lake water in and you can actually put the fish in it and actually keep them while you're fishing. So like they do in the bigger bass boats, as you've seen them.
Yeah.
And then it also has some storage units. And if you're actually looking at that picture above the big black round thing there on each side, those are actually holes that you can insert the handles of your fishing poles in.
Gotcha.
So you can, you know, you have two with you if you're using one. You can fish with both if you're just in a spot where you want to cast off both sides of your kayak. And this one here, particular one here, it looks like it blends in well. It's multicolor. The picture doesn't do it justice.
It looks like
you see it in real life.
It's very pretty.
Yeah, but it is a one-man kayak.
Okay. So that is cool, and you guys will give that away. How can you win that?
The tickets that we sell are they're just like a dollar a piece or six for five, and you're in. If you bought $5 worth, you have six chances to win something because everything comes out of the same hopper.
Okay, so you have other prizes.
Right, that's the big prize. The drawings actually start at 9 a.m.
Oh, no way.
And they do one every hour.
Do you have to be there to win?
No.
Okay.
No. Mainly when you fill it out, we want your name and your phone number. And you, and if you're not there, they'll call you when you win.
Okay, very good. So that's fantastic if you have something else going on that day. Of course, we'd love to have you out at the Trout Festival.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But if you can't be there, that's understandable.
Right. Well, there's also, for those who, you know, people start early sometimes. You know how it is if you got kids too, they got to start getting hungry or something. We're actually going to have a food stand.
Oh, awesome.
The food stand actually is the stand that the Vinton County Sheriff's Department uses to raise money for their tactical force.
Okay.
They own their own food stand, and they're going to bring the food stand out. It'll be set up right there on the road behind, right there where the shelter house is, because that's where the electric is. And so there will be some sort of food items all day. If you just want to take a break and come in and get a Pepsi or a Coke, or if you want to grab a hot dog or whatever they're selling, and you're right there, and then you go back to fishing, or you can check the sheets and see who's got the biggest trout.
There you go. Oh, I better get back out there then.
Yeah. And our president, Aaron Irvin, is working on bringing in a fellow who runs a fishing show. It's not confirmed yet, so I'm not going to say any names.
Ooh.
But there possibility could be somebody there who
maybe
actually...
Maybe a special guest.
Yeah, who does run a fishing show, He even hinted at the possibility that he might be interested in maybe even filming his show from the Trout Festival.
But no way.
But that still hasn't been confirmed.
And as you can see, there's a beautiful picture there of Hammertown Lake.
Yes.
It is just lovely and so big. It goes on forever.
Yeah.
You don't realize. And I had never realized how big Hammertown was. So I went out on a kayak one day and, you know, you turn the corner there by the dam and you think that that's it. And then it just keeps on going. So,
There's a third gate out there that a lot of people don't even realize. The third gate's off of the Beaver Pike.
Yes.
And that's where you, that goes way out where you're talking about. That you can load a boat in back there too.
Yep.
It's just not quite as nice as the other one. But
right. But it's still there.
It's still there.
Yep. Yeah. Yeah, in fact, when we were out there, ran into a friend that was kayaking, and she'd put her kayak in out there, so we met in the middle.
There you go.
But yeah, I was like, where did you come from? But all right, so I think we failed to mention, of course, the Trout Festival is put on by the Fraternal Order of Police. That's so correct. You want to talk about that for a second?
Well, that's the Fraternal Order of Police is the organization made up of law enforcement officers. Presently, I mean, our membership consists of any eligible person that's in law enforcement in Jackson County can be a member and Vinton County.
Okay, so Jackson, Vinton counties.
Right.
Okay.
And so anybody, any law enforcement officer can be a member, but you have to be a full-time law enforcement officer to be a member of the organization.
Okay.
The Fraternal Order of Police, they work on benefits. They monitor law enforcement officers' benefits on the state and national level.
Okay.
That's kind of what you're paying your dues for. Your local groups can do things to help their communities, to help raise money, you know, like we do. Our other major thing that we do is to shop with the cop.
Yeah, and while you're here, I was getting ready to ask you about that. So a Fraternal Order of Police, kind of an advocacy group, I would think, for full-time police officers, and that's wonderful. So as the Jackson Fraternal Order of Police, one of the things, I think you spearheaded it for many years, and maybe you still are, is the shop with a cop. So, you know, they're not just doing this for funsies. Like, you actually go out and help, you know, kids along the way too, which is very, very important, especially at Christmas time. So let's talk about Shop with a Cop for a minute. And that will be coming up. I mean, good grief, the way the years go, it's so quick.
Yeah. Well, when we do it, we know how people don't like, you know, nobody wants to get solicited on the phone all the time.
Right.
Okay. We have no choice. The only way that we can do that is we do it, but we only do it for the one event starting in July.
Okay.
We do the phone calls. Now, what we do is whatever the amount of money that we raised, which is the back to school part of the program. After that is we take $1,000 of that money and we seed a Christmas project where we buy coats, hats, boots, and gloves.
Yes.
So then what happens is, so in July, before school starts, when we raise the money, we buy school supplies, and that includes, you know, shoes and clothes and that type of thing. And
anything then, that kids might need to go to school.
Exactly, and their supplies, you know, paper, pencils, that type of thing.
It's expensive.
Yeah, oh yeah. And, you know, I want to throw a little thank you, because Walmart has always been made themselves available. And when we do that, we have a closed register and people come through, because we don't want people taking pictures of kids, because we want them to bring their children and we don't want their pictures taken.
Sure.
So it's not anybody's business.
Yes. No, you're right.
But what happens is, so we do that, and they've always been on board with us. They've always been a great supporter of the Shop with the Cop project.
You know, and that's just one of the things that you all do, and thank you for that, because it's been going on for, let's just say, a few years now, and has been always quite successful.
It has. Yeah.
But the Trout Festival, of course, is a way for you all to earn, I guess, a little bit of money, but also just to pay back to the community and just have a good time.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. The raffle part of this is money that goes directly to the FOP. Because, you know, we're like everybody else. We still have electric bills and utility bills, right, and property taxes, and we have to be able to pay them. And but it's still something that we can do for everybody. Mm-hmm. And we want it to be a family event.
That's right. And, you know, it's just a good time. So we'll pray that we have good weather. Because, as you said, it's been, I can remember times where it's been 80 degrees, and I can remember times where it's been snowing. Yeah. So,
you know, at 80 degrees, it's not good trout weather.
That's exactly right. Yeah. So, you need it to be, what would be ideal trout weather?
60, 65, yeah, maybe 270, no more than that.
Well, at the rate we're going, you don't have to worry about 80 degrees.
Well, I don't know. It might be 80 on Saturday and 30 on Sunday.
This is so dumb.
It's going to be 76 next Tuesday.
Ooh, mm. Yeah. There you go. Yeah, maybe we're getting there.
Yeah. I'm not crazy about the rain. You know, the rain, it just makes it more difficult.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. All right. So if somebody, number one, if somebody has questions about the Trout Festival, who do they call or how do they get information?
They can call the police department, Jackson Police Department.
Mm-hmm.
And what they'll do is give them some phone numbers. I don't really want to put my phone number out over the air.
I don't blame you.
But they can do that. There's a lot of people who do know me. I am on Facebook. So if they want to ask their question that way, sure, they can do that. That's where I've been getting most of my questions lately, has been through Facebook.
And, gotcha.
But there's, you know, you just need to show up and have fun, you know.
Just show up. Gates, again, start at 6, open at 6 a.m. on April 16th. So that's not this coming Saturday, but the following Saturday. That's so we have some time for it to warm up just a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. And, you know, you can participate all day long until 4 o'clock, right?
Right. 4 o'clock's when we give away the kayak.
So there you go.
Usually draws a pretty good crowd, too.
I'll bet.
People want to do that. We've had people for several years. There's some people that I know that may not even come out to fish, but they come out to buy chances on whatever the prize is just to support this.
Absolutely.
And, I mean, and there's a lot of good support, and it's all around here. We also get a lot of out-of-town people.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that come in because we solicit some of the information out to the other neighboring counties.
Yeah.
And it's just people like it. You know, there's always something that we're competing against. You know, I think there's an Easter egg hunt on the same day. And it used to be we missed for a couple of 3 years, turkey season was on the mm-hmm. same day. So then you've got this little fellow who's trying to decide whether his dad's going to take him fishing or hunting.
Or hunting. Yeah. Aww.
But we've got away from that weekend.
Very good. All right. So you can just come out. You can fish, have a good time, and spend the day at Hammertown Lake. And, you know, it's a beautiful place. If you don't like fishing, there's all kind of those beautiful horse trails, which you can walk. If you don't have a horse, and you can do all kind of, heck, you can fish off your horse if you want.
Yeah.
We don't care. So, all right. Butch, is there anything else you would like? Oh, I know. Where can you get chances if you can't make it out that day? Can you buy them ahead of time or anything?
Yes, you can. There's some people at the Jackson PD who has it. If you happen to be like in Vinton County,
okay,
they just need to... See, Aaron Irwin is the chief deputy in Vinton County.
Okay, yes.
And they could contact him. Him and some of his people have the tickets, too, if they want to buy them in advance.
Very good. So you can go ahead and get those if you can't make it out that day or whatever.
That's correct.
All right. Well, Butch Aldrich, thank you so much for coming in. We greatly appreciate it.
Oh, I appreciate you having me.
Anytime.
I do.
And so I think, Butch, we're going to send him over to go chat with Matt. Chat with Matt. That should be a thing.
Hey, before you go chat with Matt, you want to read the cycle search clue?
That's right. Oh. hey, you know what? And don't forget, we'll send that to Butch here in just a second. But you do have a chance, and it's getting closer, folks, to win that KO250 dirt bike with the accessories package from Total Media and Honda Suzuki Polaris Can-Am of Jackson. There it is up on the screen. And today's clue is brought to you by Mark Porter Ford and Fort Wins Community. So we want to thank them for that. All right. So we're going to give Butch the clue. So if you don't like it, it's his fault. So it's that one right there.
This one.
On Tuesday.
Okay. Ross and Pike go today. So this leaves four.
They get Ross a little confusing.
Ross and Pike go today. So this leaves four before you're ready to score.
Ooh, they're talking about counties.
Ah, I see.
So no Ross and Pike.
No Ross and Pike County.
Oh, well, right. Thank you, Butch. Okay. Very good. And we want to thank you for coming in, and we'll send you over to Matt.
Okay. Thank you.
And then while you're doing that, I'll do the weather. And then I think James is coming over, and we have a couple of videos from Jeremiah Schaefer to play. So we want to thank you for that.
Okay.
Hope that hip feels better.
A little more Friday, because I got to talk to the surgeon Friday.
Okay. All right. So let's go over your local weather forecast. And it is looking like rain in the forecast for the next couple of days and cooler temperatures today. So they are saying about an 80% chance of rain, as you can see today in the forecast, with highs only around 60, lows of 46. Stupid wind continues on. I don't know what to tell you about that. For tomorrow on Wednesday, we have partly cloudy skies, some showers still in the forecast at 70%, but warmer temperatures. So Wednesday, highs of 70, lows of 42. And then looking at Thursday, rain not in the forecast, but much cooler temperatures with highs of 61 and lows of 37. So, yeah. There you go. All right. Well, Mr. James is headed on over, and we have all kind of fun things to talk about, don't we, James?
We have so much fun things to talk about.
So much fun.
I want to kick it off with some controversy.
Controversy. I'll let you talk about it. I don't want to talk about it either. Not it.
Dang it. Well, you've got the paper, so you have to read it. So
I do.
Last night, NCAA men's championship basketball game, biggest comeback in the history of the men's championship basketball game.
That's
Kansas
right.
Kansas defeated North Carolina
yep.
by
three points. So we were watching that game.
And you thought it was over at halftime.
Well, you thought it was over at halftime. They went in North Carolina by, I believe, 15. And not looking good for Kansas. And it was one of those things where we watched it for a little bit. And I'm like, I'm just tired. I'm going to go to bed. Mm-hmm. And I remember I had it on. And I woke up. And there was 4 seconds left in the game. Yep. So it was perfect. And I woke up. And I was like, what happened? Yep. And Kansas pulled it out and won the national championship by 3 points. As you said, biggest comeback in
Crazy.
History. And pretty cool stuff. Yeah, so
pretty cool stuff. But hey, that also means Basketball Mania has a winner.
Basketball Mania has a winner right here at Total Media. And of course, giving away that $500 prize.
$600 in prizes.
That's right. $300
to first place, $200 to second place, and $100 to third place.
That's exactly right. So that's where the controversy comes in.
Yeah, so here's the thing. The rules for Basketball Mania state that you can only enter one time.
Yes.
And we found that one of our top three had multiple entries.
Yeah.
And we decided we could only accept the first entry.
Yes.
Which unfortunately was not the entry that they had that put them into the top three.
Yes.
So if you want to read, so it'll be 1, 2, and 4
yeah.
on the list you have. If you want to read our winners.
So I sure will. So the first place and congratulations in Basketball Mania contest to Alan Jarvis.
Congratulations.
Yeah, congratulations. Winning that $300 prize. Alan Jarvis, and he came up with 121 points and he did pick Kansas to win. So then the second place goes to Sydney Smith with 119 points and also picked Kansas to win. And then third place and that $100 prize goes to Joel Wood with 116 points and also picked Kansas to win. Yeah. You kind of have to pick, for the most part, you have to pick the winner or it's not going to go your way. Had North Carolina won,
I think it would have been.
It would have thrown things.
Because we didn't have very many people pick North Carolina to win.
Yeah. It would have thrown things a little bit screwy. But so Alan Jarvis, Sydney Smith, and Joel Wood, congratulations to them.
Congratulations.
The winners of the Basketball Mania.
Yeah.
Right here at Total Media. And will you guys contact them or how did they have to stop by? Yep,
stop by and get your prize money.
Yeah, stop by and get your prize money here at the Total Media
office. Of course,
those
results will be in tomorrow's Telegram, full results.
There you go.
Yep.
That's awesome.
It is awesome.
Yeah.
I hate that we had that little snafu.
I know. It's going to be controversial, but the rules are the rules, and the rules were clearly stated.
Yeah.
So, better yet.
What did I finish at?
Where did James K. Hamilton finish in?
I think 308.
Out of?
Like 320 or something like that.
Not only did he lose the office pool by like a lot, he lost the whole thing by like a lot.
Yeah.
It's okay. We still love
you. Hey, man. Next year's my, just like with Bengals. The Bengals.
next year's the year. God.
Oh my. So moving on. Less controversial news. We got a new business in Jackson.
Yes.
Rugged Earth Outfitters.
We do. And I need to stop by there. Yeah. I'm super excited about it.
I stopped by there Saturday morning. I guess that was the morning they had their official grand opening. It's a bigger store than you probably think it's gonna be. More stuff than you probably think is gonna be in there.
Ooh.
I know we talked about it a little bit yesterday.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was nice. It was, like I said, it's bigger than you probably expect it to be in there. It seems like kind of a small space, but they had a lot of stuff.
Awesome.
Yeah, it was really nice, really cool. But Jeremiah was also there Saturday morning, and he did some interviews and stuff with the store manager, Aaron Jones.
Okay.
And give us a little tour of the store.
That I would love to see because I haven't been in there in person. Yeah. So maybe I can stop in there this afternoon.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
Yeah.
So I think let's
I can talk about it.
So let's take this quick little tour. This love is just a couple minutes long.
Awesome. So let's check this out. Jeremiah.
Yeah, thank you, Jeremiah, for putting this stuff together for us this morning.
Yeah, and we have a few more little ditties from Jeremiah.
Yeah, so. and Brock Netter and Pete Wilson, too.
There you go.
The whole team's getting in here.
Heck
all right.
Yeah.
So let's head on out to Rugged Earth Outfitters. Yep.
Rugged Earth Outfitters, located at 532 Main Street in Jackson, held a ribbon cutting prior to its grand opening on Saturday, April 2nd. The new business is located in the Jackson Square Shopping Center and features sports, workwear, outdoor wear for men and women, with such brands as Carhartt, Dickies, Wolverine, to name a few.
Hello, I'm Aaron Jones. I'm the store manager here at Rugged Earth Outfitters. Just to give you a little bit of background about our company, we're actually, our parent company is Bell's in Florida, and the company started around 1914, and E.R. Bell founded it in 1914, which they branched out over the years. They also own Burke's Outlet. It's just right three doors down from us, and now this is a new venture of theirs where we sell workwear. We got Dickies, Wolverine, Carhartt, Ariat, I don't know how to say that word just yet, but it's one of those two. Speaking of the beginnings of the company, E.R. Bell's grandson is running the company today, and it's a completely privately owned company. It's like a mom and pop store on a national level. So, and I know that I've only been with the company for a year now myself, but this is truly a good company to work for, and we are always looking for new talent if you're interested. Again, my name is Aaron. I'll be here until about 5 o'clock today. Feel free to stop on by and say, hey, I seen you on that thing. So, but thank you guys very much.
All right. Thank you.
The store hours are 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. Monday through Saturday and 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. on Sundays. More information about the business can be found at www.ruggedearth.com, and look for a story in a future edition of the Telegram.
So Jen, wow, you know what? Awesome. Yeah, so you know what you got to do now. You got to go in there and find Aaron and say, hey,
I saw you on that thing.
So if anyone does that, we will give you a prize.
That's right.
I don't know what the prize is. We'll figure it out. It'll be the snack I have to buy Courtney.
Yeah, right. So are you going to buy her beef jerky, or are you going to buy her something real?
I'll have a conversation with her about it later today. But thanks again to Jeremiah for putting that together. That's nice.
You know, it's super exciting. Anytime you get a fun store like that in a local community where you don't have to buy, you know, drive to the big city to get your Carhartt gear or your, you know, hiking gear or something like that, it's fantastic. So please take advantage of having all that local stuff right here. And, you know, Burke's is a wonderful store as well. So you can check that out. You know, that plaza is now full, and I was looking at that yesterday. I was like, are there any empty spaces in that? And I don't think that there are.
I don't think so.
You know, you have the Big Lots store. You have, you know, some other smaller stores on the side there, a new nail salon, and I think a cell phone store and some other things. So, yeah, it's a really nice little area here in downtown Jackson. So stop by and see it.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Hey, speaking of shopping, another thing that Jeremiah has been reporting on, the Wellston City School District is making sure no student goes without basic needs such as food and clothing. So the Wellston Middle School has set up what they're calling the Rocket Shop.
What?
Yeah. So So this is pretty cool. So this is another little segment Jeremiah put together for us.
Okay.
So why don't we check this out, because it's pretty cool too.
The Rocket Shop.
The Rocket Shop.
I love that.
Yeah, it's a cute name.
Yep.
In an effort to make sure no students go without some basic needs, such as food, the Wellston City School District has started implementing something to help. Last year, Wellston City School's Food Service Director Tina King had applied for a grant with No Kid Hungry through affiliate Children's Hunger Alliance. In fall 2021, the Wellston City Schools received word that they had been awarded a $30,000 grant. King took that grant, which was geared towards feeding children in need, and opened a food pantry at the Wellston Middle School.
I'm Tina King. I'm Food Service Supervisor here at Wellston City Schools.
My name is Brandy Cuff. I'm the principal here at Wellston Middle School.
Okay, so tell us about this room we're in.
We have decided to complete a pantry here at Wellston Middle School with clothing, as you can see, and all the foods. We have Children's Hunger Alliance with the No Kid Hungry Act has helped us with a grant. We've got a lot of donated foods, and all of the clothing is donated clothing, some new, some gently used. We use it, down here is the girls' clothing, and upstairs we have a boys' pantry for all the boys' clothing. We graciously purchased the refrigerator with the grant. Brandy has helped us with the room, the areas that we've needed. We have students' help. I'll let Brandy tell more a little bit about that. But we're trying to keep it going and keeping all the students in need.
So we have expanded we'll call it the Rocket Shop here at Wellston Middle School. It was an effort that started on our second floor in really two smaller closets. So with lots of help, with lots of donations, and lots of generous resources brought to us, we have expanded this area into, like Tina said, our clothing, our coats, our shoes, toiletries, school supplies, food items, non-perishable and perishable, which will be available to our kids. So we are really excited about these opportunities and very excited for the leadership that is behind all these efforts. Tina being a prime force, also Susie Gearing in our world of work, and the students within. Club Kindness has also been a leader in terms of our pantries and our culture. closet, so they will continue to work the area, and in some cases students will be paid for that. So we're very excited to be able to offer this to our kids.
Children's Hunger Alliance School and Summer Nutrition Manager Thomas Benn visited the middle school on Tuesday, March 15th to see the new food pantry in action. Ben was impressed by the pantry, but noted that maintaining it into the future would be the challenge. King is hoping that the community will help with donations of food. She told the Telegram that some local businesses are also signing up to donate to the pantry, and she plans on looking into other grant opportunities.
What a great idea.
Yeah. And thank you, Jeremiah, for putting that together for us again.
He's everywhere.
He's everywhere.
He is.
Yeah. Very cool.
No, that's a really good idea. And, you know, when kids need something quick or whatever, mm-hmm. It's right there for them.
Yeah. It's really nice.
Yeah. Very for sure. Cool.
You know, so for those that don't know,
there's definitely a powwow going on.
So for those that don't know, Rodney Porterhouse Tomlin is back with Total Media full time now. So anytime you see us get distracted and look like that, it's probably because he's causing a commotion in the hallway.
The very thing that makes Rodney so wonderful as a personality continues on off the air a lot of times worse. And so it's nothing to just hear a ginormous scream in the middle of the hallway. So
is this a random belly laugh or you're singing along with the music?
So yeah. Exciting. That was Rodney. Yeah.
Exciting stuff going on here.
So no, it's very fun to have Rodney and JJ
absolutely.
Back.
Absolutely.
We will maybe we can get them in here together. Yeah. Although I probably wouldn't have to be here for that. So that's fine. We can just set them down.
Well, you got a vacation. I don't know. Pete Wilson's got a vacation coming up. We get them to do the news.
There you go. Oh, God, no. Anything but the news. The news has to be kind of serious.
Kind of.
All right. So Jeremiah was out and about, was one more time, right?
Yeah. Well, we just mentioned Rodney and JJ joining our team, but they're not the only new members of the Telegram team.
What?
We've also welcomed Brock Netter as a sports editor to the Telegram.
Okay.
And so he's been out covering lots of high school baseball and softball so far, because that season is in full swing.
'Tis the season.
Yeah. And so earlier in this week, he interviewed Wellston softball players Hannah Potts and Jenna Johnson, who discussed their TVC opener win over Athens. Get this, 12-1.
Whoa.
Whooped them. So this was last Friday, and they both hit home runs in the fourth inning.
Awesome, girls.
Yeah. So let's go check this out real quick. And thanks to Brock for sending this in to us.
Our mindset really once we started the season was one game at a time. We thought about this game, you know, Athens, big rivalry in the TVC. And we just came in with the mindset with last year, they gave us our one loss in the TVC, and we just kind of kept that chip on our shoulder, came into this game and said, we got to stay up the whole game no matter what, and then see what happened when we stayed up the whole game.
Just hitting my spots, my spins, just that was my main focus, and just pitching out, not trying to strike them out. I know I got my defense behind me, and I know they'll take care of it if I don't. I just saw and was like, yep, taking a hack, and I've been really working on my swing this past season and starting to pay off. I saw an opportunity, my runner's on base, and I was like, I just gotta find a pitch I can drive, wait for the pitcher to miss a spot, and then take it and put some more runs on the board. This being a big win shows us what we can do as a team collectively, and just moving on, we have to keep it one game at a time.
So we gotta give a shout out to Hannah's hat.
Oh, we do.
Yeah. Jenna, step your hat game up. If you're gonna be doing interviews,
we can't be conservative next to Hannah, here with this hat.
Yeah, you gotta step up the hat game.
Yeah.
That maybe thing we is could send next one. Level.
It was next level for sure.
That was
yes.
Really nice hat.
Yes.
Hey, I wanna go back to something Butch was talking about.
Sure.
He said that there's maybe going to be someone from a fishing TV show
yes.
at the Trout Festival. So I don't know any fishing TV shows, so I just gave it a Google to see if I could figure out who it is. Well, there's a lot more fishing TV shows than you would think.
There are.
But yes. There's one in particular. Now, I guess this isn't on the air anymore, but it stood out to me.
Oh, gosh.
So what do you call the part of the fishing? Would you put on the line and cast it out?
The lure?
Well, another
the bobber?
Name, well, the part that actually, like...
The hook.
The hook. So there's a fishing show entitled Top Hooker.
Nuh-uh. So fitting.
Yeah. So I think they know what they were doing with that name. Top Hooker. Because the episode one of Top Hooker is entitled The Oldest Profession.
Love it.
So I don't know. I mean, it could be you know,
dude. If we maybe
it could be somebody from Top Hooker is going to be at the Trout Festival.
Maybe the hooker, the mm-hmm. Top Hooker, will be here.
Yeah, I mean, it could also be someone from Deadliest Catch, Long Live the King, or River Monsters, or what's a, there's a Big Fish Man.
Big Fish Man. Woo!
Or a fishing story with Ronnie Green. I mean, Ronnie Green, the man himself, could be there. I don't know.
It's possible.
Yeah. Hooked on fishing.
Wow, they're so original.
Yeah. So, yeah.
I like the...
I figured that there was probably, like, one person that was, like, the celebrity and, like,
yeah, fishing. Yeah, no.
Apparently not.
It's a thing.
Yeah. When he first said that, the first thing that came to my mind was, you remember in Ghostbusters 2 when Bill Murray has the, like, psychic talk show and he's, like, interviewing psychics and stuff, and he's talking to this security guard at, like, a hotel or something, and the security guard's like, I love your show. It's my second favorite show. And he's like, what's your first favorite? He's like, Bassmasters.
It's a thing.
So, yeah, so I'm excited to see what fishing celebrity.
Maybe. Oh, we'll no, see.
It's exciting.
We'll see. No, that reminds me. Jamie and I were watching a show last night on, I don't know, Food Network or one of them, because that's what we end up watching. I mean, we mm-hmm. could just subscribe to Food Network and that would be it. But anyway, is there an app for that?
Probably. Yeah.
So they have these shows where they go and visit different restaurants mm-hmm. and stuff. And the one was called last night Cold Beer Hot Burgers or something like that. Hey, and I was like,
don't we have that show on 97.7?
No, that's Free Beer and Hot Wings. But nice.
Cold Beer and Hot Burgers.
And I'm like, so Jamie wasn't paying attention and I was. So I'm sitting there waiting for him to say something about it. And they get halfway through their little thing, and he goes, did they just say the name of that restaurant is Cold Beer and Hot Burgers? I'm like, yep. I'm like, it's actually kind of genius yeah. because it was just so basic, but their uh-huh. but their food looked amazing. Yeah. So it was just kind of almost a pun or a That's play funny. On
yeah.
Basic.
I am a fan of like really small restaurants that just have signs that just say what it is.
Yeah, like bar.
Yeah, just as bar. Or, yeah,
we went to a bar. There was a place in Columbus that just said bar
yeah.
on it.
Yeah, I think that stuff's funny. Like it just says sandwiches.
Yeah.
Like they don't have a name. It just is the sign that sandwiches. Just says sandwiches.
Fantastic.
Love it.
Maybe we should do that.
Yeah.
I like it.
Mm-hmm. So we should rebrand Sixth Sense as just beer. Yeah.
Just beer.
Just beer.
Burritos. Period.
One of my friends, he went to like Myrtle Beach or someplace like that, one of the touristy places. And he went to this gift shop and they had beer in there. It just said they had two kinds. One just said beer. The other one just said light beer.
Nuh-uh.
It's just a silver can with blue letters. It just said light beer.
Ew, what was that?
No.
Don't drink that. I don't know what it is, but don't drink it.
I don't know.
Scary.
Yeah. When I did my study abroad thing, I remember you could buy beer in plastic 2-liter bottles, like like soda.
Nuh-uh.
I mean, it wasn't good, but you could buy it.
That is so gross.
It's pretty gross.
Yeah.
Yeah. I heard a commercial on the radio on the way in this morning. Uh-huh. for this new Pepsi that's like made with nitrous?
Nitro Pepsi. No, what? No, no.
What is that?
So nitro makes things creamy and flat.
Yeah.
Tasting like Guinness is right. Nitro.
Yeah.
So, yes, I keep seeing that commercial. I'm like, no, no. Yeah. Everything that's like, everything that like soda stands mm-hmm. for is the antithesis.
Yeah,
of that.
It is really weird. They're talking about how the bubbles are smaller.
It's basically going to taste like flat Pepsi yeah. with some cream in it.
Right. So the Coke, of course, has that Coke with coffee
yeah.
right now. And I tried that because I'm a big iced coffee fan. I yeah. like Coke. And it just tastes like flat Coke. So I'm kind of, yeah, I kind of no. figured that that's probably what this is too.
Yeah. Nitro Pepsi. We need to get one.
Yeah. We're going to have to get it.
Okay. But like darn it.
The commercial was just so weird. They're like, that means it's got smaller bubbles. I was like, what? like I've never heard anybody like have a soda and be like, man, I wish these bubbles were smaller.
No. Okay. Now we've got to try yeah. it. Darn
it's so
it.
Weird.
Right here on the program.
We'll look for it.
Someone bring us a Nitro Pepsi. Yeah.
We'll look for it. This weird stuff.
Yeah. And it's like, so, by the way, Anheuser-Busch Bud Light has come out with this even less calorie beer than Michelob Ultra. I'm like,
just water what? With a little bit of yellow food coloring.
Yeah. I'm like, what is it then? I mean, Ultra's got like two carbs in it. Like, what? Yeah. How could you get less than that?
I don't know, man.
We'll have to try that too.
Yep.
All right, so we'll be drinking at 9 a.m, but yeah, whatever. But Trust us, it won't affect us in any way, shape, or form, because it's basically like what you said, fizzy yeah. yellow water. Yeah. So, anyway.
Yeah, anyway.
But we digress.
Yeah, we digress. So, Telegram editor Pete Wilson interviewed freshman pitchers Tucker Williams and Nolan Johnson, who both pitched shutout baseball games for the Jackson Ironmen.
What?
And their two wins over Memphis, 4-3, well, one over Memphis and one over Warren Local. The Memphis game was 4-3. The Warren Local game was 1-0. This was last Saturday. I watched the Memphis game and joined Pete on the radio a little bit. Man, that was an exciting game. The Ironmen had yeah. a 3-run lead going into the 5th inning. Memphis had a big rally, came back, tied the game. Pitcher got out of trouble, bases loaded. It was an exciting inning, and it's like brand new ball game. Like, man, what's going to happen now?
Mm-hmm.
And I wish I could remember the kid's name off the top of my head. Comes up for the Ironman first batter of the 6th inning, hits a freaking bomb over that big wall. That's
way.
Yeah, where they have that like that storage shed there,
yeah.
and they built the walls like 3 times taller. Just freaking bombed it over that thing. On like, I mean, it wasn't the first pitch, but it was. You know, second or third pitch of the at bat.
Nice.
Just freaking killed it. And so that led Jackson to a 4-3 win. So that was super exciting. But after that second game, which I didn't hang around, but I guess Pete Wilson came back for it, he talked with these two kids about it. So
very good.
Yeah. So let's
our Jackson
check
baseball
out.
Team, very exciting.
Yeah,
stuff.
They're 3-4-0.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. So let's check out what Pete and these kids had to say.
We're here at Dick Sparky Haller Field, where the Jackson Ironmen have just won 2 games in a row. They defeated Medford 4-3 in the first game, and then they beat Warren Local just a minute ago here in the third game and their second game of the day. Two freshman pitchers played big roles in the two victories. First of all, on my left, Tucker Williams pitched 6 shutout innings to help his team win over Warren Local 1-0, while Nolan Johnson on the right pitched 4 shutout innings in a game that Jackson won over Medford 4-3. Okay, gentlemen, starting with Tucker, how do you feel about starting your varsity career with a start, 6 innings, shutout ball?
It was exciting. I was a little anxious to begin with, but got in the groove of things and really got going. It felt really good.
All right, and Nolan, how about you? Medford's a very good team. You went 4 shutout innings, and your team ended up winning. So I know you played a lot of football this past year, but how did this compare with the pitching shutout ball against Medford?
Well, you can't be coming out here expecting every single day to pitch shutout innings. It feels great to get out here and get a debut and know that, you know, your team trusts you to come out on the mound and just perform to the best of your ability. You got eight great defensive players behind you, hardly any errors, making plays all over the field. So it's wonderful.
All right. I know both of you are multi-sports guys. You play other sports as well. What do you think about being part of this baseball team, and how well do you think they can do this year?
Well, we can get far, and that's our goal. Our goal is to be that state tournament, and I think we can do it, sure.
All right. And Nolan?
You got, like I said, you got great leadership on this team. I mean, you got big seniors, you know, coming back to play, been playing baseball their whole life. I mean, they come out here and they help you, they give you tips, tricks, whatever they need to do, settle you in and, you know, calm your nerves down. So obviously when you come out here for the first time, you're going to be nervous. You know, you got to feel like you got to prove yourself to the people, but it's more than that. You know, see, when you've got good leadership and stuff, it really helps out.
All right. Well, gentlemen, congratulations on great outings, both of you.
And thank you to Pete for doing that interview. And Jeremiah kind of cleaned the audio up for us a little bit. And, of course, thank you to Tucker and Nolan for taking the time to chat with us. That was awesome.
That's right. And those are some youngsters. So, you know,
yeah.
There's a lot of senior leadership on that team. But as you can tell, the younger players are stepping up right away. Yeah. So that's amazing.
That's impressive. Yeah. These kids are good. And like we were saying, like, off air while that was playing, like, man, can you imagine how stressful it is being on the mound in those games?
No,
you got, you know, the bases loaded, like nobody out, and you're on the mound having to deal with that at 16 years old or whatever.
No,
it's impressive.
No
very
way,
impressive.
Yes,
no thanks.
No thanks.
Then the Ironmen, I don't know their full schedule off the top of my head, but they will be back on the radio at home this Friday.
Okay,
so Pete will be there, weather permitting. I know there are some games tonight. Oak Hill plays Wellston in Oak Hill tonight. Forecast is not looking very good for baseball, though, so we'll see.
We'll what see. Happens. Hey, listen, it's springtime, and the forecast can change 14 times in one day, so we'll see.
Yeah, we sure will. But yeah, I mean, a lot of exciting stuff going on.
Very good.
Yeah. And we want to thank again, Jeremiah, Brock, and Pete for putting all that stuff together.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure you're following the Telegram on Facebook to see little videos like this pop up from time to time.
Yeah, and that's the great thing about social media is, you know, while we want you to still subscribe to the paper and have access to all that, you can have access a little bit earlier to some of these other things by, you know, jumping online or checking it out.
Talking about that subscription to the paper, like, that's how we're able to do this stuff.
Yes.
You know,
that's right.
The money that comes from those subscriptions are why we're able to do things like that for free.
So please subscribe to the paper. It's very, very minimal cost. There's senior discounts. There's, I think, student discount. There's all kind of like different things.
Like the senior discount your stepdad qualifies for now.
Yeah, Davey got his senior discount yesterday. Yes. Not that he's old or anything. But no, $48 for an entire year's worth of news and, you know,
twice
local
a week,
news.
Free access to the website.
That's the main thing, you know, free access to all the articles that come out early, even breaking news articles, things like that. So yeah, I mean, for $48 a year, that's the deal of the century.
Yeah, I mean, it really is. Like, I've looked at other local newspapers, and it's three times that for papers that publish less.
Yes, absolutely.
It really is.
The Telegram staff keeps updated, and they keep everything at your fingertips, literally, if you just subscribe and you pay attention. Yeah. And, you know, breaking news stuff, accidents, anything crazy going on, they're going to let you know about it.
Absolutely.
So
sports, all that good
stuff. All that stuff.
Yep. So, we got Apple Festival Queen contests and stuff coming up.
That's right. Is that Easter week? When's Easter?
Easter is the 17th.
Okay. So it'll be that weekend.
Yeah.
Same weekend as the Trout Festival.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. So you can go out fishing during the day and then go to the Queen contest at night.
Yeah.
Little Queens on Friday, Big Queens on Saturday.
Big Queens.
Or the Queen.
I'm a big queen. We got some exciting guests coming up in the next few weeks.
I'm pumped about. Super exciting.
Wildlife Officer Ted Witham is going to be back.
Love Ted.
One of our favorite guests from last year, Jess Kelly Adams, is going to be back.
That's right. And I'll bet you anything Fancy will be with her.
I have confirmed that Fancy will be joining us.
Yay! If you don't know, that's her puppy.
Yes.
Very pretty dog.
Yes.
And then here's the one I'm super excited about. Mr. Speed.
Yes.
Kiss tribute band. So we're going to be chatting with some of the guys from Mr. Speed.
Are they going to be here in studio or are we going to do
They're from the Cleveland area, so okay. They're going to have to call in remotely. But
are they going to dress up?
I don't think they sleep with the makeup on, and I don't think they're going to get up at 9 a.m. and put it on. But
it's going to be fun.
It is. So cool. I bet there's a Snapchat filter we can put on them and make them look like Kiss.
You're exactly right about that. We better get on that ahead of time.
Do that to you. Yeah. Or maybe we should actually paint you up. You don't have anything else to do.
No.
Let's get up at 6 a.m. and do that.
We'll paint Jen.
Yep.
But no, we have a lot of guests coming up, some in the works. So, look forward to a lot of fun things coming your
way. Yeah, man. Pumped.
Super pumped. Hey, are you watching Super Pumped?
No, I don't know what that is. Is that a fishing show?
No.
Super Pumped and America's Next Top Hooker.
We should combine all that together.
Anyway, thank you all for watching.
Yeah. No, Super Pumped is the show about Uber. The whole beginning.
Okay.
Oh boy.
No, I wasn't aware of this.
Oh yeah, it's good. We I don't know what it's on. I don't know what channel it's on. I DVR it. It's something at my house that I have. Okay. HBO
it's
or something.
On, so if you want to watch Super Pumped, it's on Jennifer's DVR.
It's on my DVR. Yeah. So just come on out and you can watch it.
Right.
But no, it is, man, Uber, wow. How that is still a company, I will never know.
Yeah.
It is, wow. Let's just to say their culture was a little less than desirable when they first started. Gonna leave it at that.
All right. So, well, there we go.
All right. Have a great day.
Yeah.
And you have a great day. We're gonna go out and look for the cycle search clue key. Oh,
we got an idea. We're not gonna. We
have two ideas.
We'll talk about our ideas at the end of the week.
Yeah, we can we'll do
save
that.
Save it. Okay. Or maybe next week. I don't know. Yeah,
James and I both were thinking kind of the same thing. So we're narrowing it down in our minds.
Yeah, we're cheating. We're looking ahead. Shh, don't tell anybody.
But we will not tell you. All right. Have a great day, everyone. Thank you so much for tuning in, and we'll be right back here tomorrow.
Bye, guys.